In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to you all as we come together for our Mass today. And when I say you all, I mean a few of us here at St. Simon's in person, and for those of you who, through your phone, iPad, TV, or whatever, are part of our virtual Mass. On today, November the 11th, it's Remembrance Day, a day in which we give special prayerful recognition of those who have given their lives or who have served in the defence of our nation over, I think I worked it out the other day, last 100 years. It's roughly a third of that 100 years that Australia has been engaged in war activities somewhere in the world. The two world wars, of course, Korea, Vietnam, Afghanistan and Iraq being the ones that come to mind, but other areas such as peacekeeping in Timor and various other places where the Australian forces have served on our behalf. And this is the day where in 1918 the armistice was declared and the end of World War One was declared, and to the great relief of people all over the globe. Little did they know that 20 years later it will all be on again with even greater vengeance. So we're aware in our own time of the way in which the world can come to a stop through all sorts of different circumstances of threats, and in this case, of course, of health, but the threat of violence and tyranny and so on is very difficult to manage indeed. So we're grateful to all those who, on our behalf as Australians, have served in our name. It's the feast of St. Martin of Tours, and Tours, of course, is in the west of France. I'm not sure if he's a patron saint of travel agents or not with a name like that, but he was Tours in France and he was a soldier. We'll talk a little bit more about that a little later on. So we'll pause for a moment and we'll ask God's forgiveness for our sins. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have poured out on your people the Spirit of truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd, leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, you are glorified in the Bishop St. Martin, both by his life and by his death. Make new the wonders of your grace in our hearts, so that neither death nor life may separate us from your love. Almighty everlasting God, you sent your Son to die so that we might live. Grant eternal rest to all those who have given themselves in the service and in sacrifice for their country. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the poor, to bind up hearts that are broken, to proclaim liberty to captives, freedom to those in prison, to proclaim a year of favour from the Lord, a day of vengeance for our God, to comfort all those who mourn and to give them for ashes a garland, for mourning robe the oil of gladness, for despondency praise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. Through all ages my mouth will proclaim your truth. Of this I am sure, that your love lasts forever, that your truth is firmly established as the heavens.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David my servant. I will establish your dynasty forever and set up your throne through all ages.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I have found David my servant, and with my holy oil anointed him. My hand shall always be with him, and my arm shall make him strong.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
My truth and my love shall be with him. By my name his might shall be exalted. He will say to me, "You are my Father, my God, the rock who saves me."
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Please stand to welcome the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. I give you a new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, escorted by all the angels, then he will take his seat on his throne of glory. All the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate men one from another as the shepherd separates sheep from goats. He will place the sheep on his right hand and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, 'Come, you whom my Father has blessed, take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you made me welcome. Naked, and you clothed me. Sick, and you visited me. In prison, and you came to see me.' Then the virtuous will say to him in reply, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and make you welcome, naked and clothed you, sick or in prison, and went to see you?' And the king will answer, 'I tell you solemnly, insofar as you did this to one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did it to me.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Trying to blend together the Feast of St. Martin of Tours and Remembrance Day, as we're trying to do in this Mass, was not really all that difficult, because St. Martin of Tours was a soldier, and like many of the saints of that early era of the Church, he was a Roman soldier serving in Gaul. And he was a Christian, and he came across a beggar, so the legend has it. And I should have checked all this out beforehand, but my memory serves me correctly. The beggar had no protection from the elements whatsoever, and St. Martin cut his own cloak in half for the beggar. Anyhow, as the story goes on, the beggar turns out to be Jesus, hence the choice of that gospel that I've just read as being very appropriate, that this act of total charity and kindness, and really, you might say in our terms, giving him the shirt off his own back, so to speak, in different circumstances. But the fact that he was a soldier, of course, links us with the whole notion of remembrance, service, unselfishness, sacrifice in terms of our own nation. And we have 2 days a year in which that is recognised in a formal way, Anzac Day and Remembrance Day. And Anzac Day, of course, probably has the greater focus. Remembrance Day does have a focus. I was privileged to be in Canberra actually about 5 years ago, about 2015, I think it was, with a friend who was a Vietnam veteran, and we were there on the 11th of November for all the ceremonies that took place on that day. And it was a very moving experience to be with him and with his wife, who'd been with him for, they'd been married for nearly 50 years at that stage, and he has since died, sadly, from, well, situations which arose as a result of his service. And my friendship with him over the years has alerted me for the last 25 years or so to the whole notion of post-traumatic stress, what that does to people who have, particularly young people, in most cases probably young men in combat, but now even women can be involved in the armed forces in those situations. And so PTSD, as they call it, is not uncommon at all. And maybe on this Remembrance Day, we might give prayerful remembrance not only to those who have died, but those who have come back carrying the burden of what they have experienced, and of the families who have supported them through all sorts of areas of difficulty, none of which is the fault of any of them. But the impact of what they have experienced. I remember when the movie Saving Private Ryan came out, in the first 20 minutes, maybe even half an hour, was the D-Day landings. And it was spoken by many people who experienced those landings that this was the closest they'd ever seen in film to what really happened. And if you're not someone that can manage this, don't watch it. It's grim stuff. But people who were there said, well, this is what it was like. And it was just awful. And we're talking in large degree of people who were 18, 19, early 20s, but it wouldn't matter what age you were, to go through that in those circumstances, you could not ever be the same again. Now, it's not just only in war, but certainly these are people who have done this for you and for me, so that we might have the life that we take for granted. And we grizzle and groan about COVID-19 and restrictions and so on, and maybe that's understandable to a degree. But compared to what others have suffered, what they have brought back to Australia with them, often being whisked away out of a battle zone, maybe in Vietnam when their tour of duty was over, if they'd survived and hadn't been wounded, within 24 hours they'd be back at their family dinner table, and the family would wonder why they were as they were. So the long and convoluted story goes out. Let's be aware of them. I did mention in our parish email that we send out each week, this week, a movie which, for those of you who are watching this on our YouTube channel, you might look this up if you can find it. A marvellous recent, it's a US film, but it's about an American Air Force helicopter medic in the Air Force, but it's an examination of the whole effect of post-traumatic stress on the people that he saved. It's a true story, and he received eventually, after a battle of over 40 years by the people who were with him on his day of extraordinary courage, that he received the American Congressional Medal of Honor. So, well worth a look. The Last Full Measure, and it's on Netflix. And if you don't have Netflix, well, find a next door neighbour who does and watch it together. But that's what we can do today, to remember those who have served in our nation, but maybe especially to remember those who still carry the scars. What were the scars that Martin of Tours carried? Because talk about savagery in battle. You look back and see the way they played for keeps in the days of Roman domination of the world, and people have been playing for keeps, as we say, ever since in terms of war and battles. So maybe it is appropriate that we've got St. Martin of Tours today
on Remembrance Day. He discovered Jesus, he gave to Jesus, and in doing something for the beggar, he did it for Jesus himself. And maybe there's a way we can link all of those things together as we pray for those who have served our nation, and particularly those who are still paying a very heavy price for the gift of freedom that they have given to us. Our prayers of intercession. Help us to live the new life of Easter so that people may know through us the power of your love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Every day is a proof of your love. As you bring us to this day, make us new in mind and in heart. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach us to see you present in others. Help us to recognize you most of all in those who are suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for all those in our community who have been saddened by loss. We especially remember the families who hold a place in our parish and school community. Lord, hear us.
Jesus, healer of all, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for peace and liberty all over the world. Lord, hear us.
Jesus, healer of all, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for all those who are experiencing loss. May they find comfort in their memories. Lord, hear us.
Jesus, healer of all, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for all of the organisations who work to help and support those who have suffered loss. Lord, hear us.
Jesus, healer of all, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for all those here today. May we all be peaceful in our own world. Lord, hear us.
Jesus, healer of all, hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we gather today in this special place to remember those in the community who are with you. We ask that you look after them and also watch over their families and friends till we are all united once again. Lord, hear us.
Jesus, healer of all, hear our prayer.
Maybe on this Remembrance Day, we can pray this very special prayer for all those who have served our country and in our name. We pray to honour those who have sacrificed their lives so that we can enjoy the freedom and prosperity of this great nation. We thank you for the courage of those who gave their lives that we might live. We thank you, Lord, for the patience and steadfastness of those who, having survived the conflict of war, have carried their scars back to Australia, but have continued to serve their country despite their suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you for the medical personnel who have cared for them in wartime and in peace, and brought them as much comfort and healing as is possible. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to remember them as we do on this day each year, making us aware of the value of unselfishness, bravery, and sacrifice. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And Lord, on this Remembrance Day, as we honour them and pray for them, we ask that we may be true to the example that they have given, so that we may also be ambassadors of freedom and courage to all those around us, and so that we might serve others in the same way that they have given of themselves for us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And Lord, we make these prayers today through Jesus Christ, your Son, who sacrificed himself for all people of every nation. Amen.
And on this Remembrance Day, in addition to all those who have given of their lives in the service of our nation, we place also for those whose names are in our parish memorial book: Annette Jackson, Joseph Francis, Kay Anstey, Emmanuel de Brinkett, Eslyn Hughes, Nelia Kellett, and Clarence Lobo. We place them all in God's love and care. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Just with this wine. That we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
God, we ask you to receive us, we please, with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, bless you. Let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Lord, sanctify these offerings which we joyfully present in honour of St. Martin. May our life be always guided by them, whether in tribulation or in prosperity. Heavenly Father, grant that the sacrifice of Jesus, who laid down his life for his friends, may raise to the victory of eternal life all those who have died in war. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, so that those saddened by the certainty of death might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Special remembrance for all those who have served in our name in wartime and have lost their lives or have died often enough as a result of the suffering that they have endured. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour are yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And wherever we are, and whoever we're with, we offer each other the sign of peace and friendship in Christ. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Recognition of the mystery of the Eucharist, which is the very core of our faith in Jesus, we pray this beautiful spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you to live in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, grant to us who have been restored by this sacrament of unity perfect harmony in all things with your will. Just as St. Martin submitted himself entirely to you, so too may we glory in being truly yours. Lord, by our communion with this sacrament, grant us courage in the cause of right. May our remembrance of those who have died in defence of our nation make us defenders of your peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just before concluding, I'll do this again on our Mass next weekend, if I remember. And that is, I've got a file at home, and on the front of it is a label saying, emails that have been sent in recognition of our online Masses. Now, it's about that thick. I haven't got around to responding to them, and I probably eventually will, but for those of you who have been wonderfully kind in your comments, in your support, in your encouragement, and in some cases in being very generous in terms of contribution to the parish, can I just take this opportunity to say thank you to you for the wonderful response that you give. The best response of all is the fact that you are watching and that the Mass can be of help to you. But for those many of you who have taken the trouble to indicate that it has been appreciated, well, your appreciation is appreciated by us. And even if I hadn't had the courtesy yet of getting back to you, I know you will understand that life is a little frantic in those areas, but one of these days I'll surprise you and I'll get there. But in the meantime, I hope you can take this on board on behalf of myself, of Peter, our cinematographer, of all of our staff, and everyone who makes the Mass possible, the people who do all the behind-the-scenes work getting things ready. We appreciate your words of thanks indeed. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.